Hello friends and good day. This is Fred with Tech Talk and we are coming at you today with a video on what to do in the event that you have plugged in a network IP camera into your LAN using a PoE switch and you are unable to locate its IP address. You can't find the camera on the network. We have had a previous video on the advanced IP scanning tool. And from that video, we received a couple of comments. I'm going to put one up right now from Cody. But in a nutshell, this says, hey, you know, I followed your video, I did what you said, and I'm still unable to locate my IP cameras on the network. Please help. Okay. This can occur because of a couple of factors. Okay. The most common is these cameras, when they are shipped out of the box from the manufacturer, most of them are shipped with a static IP address. Okay. What that means is the IP address is pre-configured in the camera. With Hikvision, that IP address is 192.168.1.64. And when this plugs into your network, it can only be located at that IP address. Okay. Most network devices in modern technology, when you plug them in, they are in what's called DHCP mode, and they allow the router or the routing device in your network to give it an IP address. Most of these cameras won't. You'll have to log into them manually and put them into DHCP mode, which will allow them to communicate with your network. It's not a difficult process. We're going to cover it right now. Let's get into the meat and potatoes. Before we do, you know the drill. There is a subscribe button in the bottom right hand corner of your screen. Please subscribe to our channel if you have not already done so. That way you'll be notified when we post future content. Also like the video if it's useful to you and leave comments. Again, this video is based on Cody's comment. We're not going to get into an advanced networking class today, but it is important to understand how a routing process works in a home or small business, okay? You will have a modem from your internet service provider. Some modems are modems slash routers. Those will give you Wi-Fi directly from the internet service provider's modem. When I say internet service provider, ISP, I'm referring to, you know, Verizon, Comcast, Atlantic Broadband, Cox, all of those guys. Those are internet service providers. So they'll come into your home, and they'll hook up a modem, okay? And that modem will either have a built-in router or oftentimes it will be hooked to your own router, okay? A lot of people have Linksys, Netgear routers, stuff like that plugged into your modem. And the clients in your home connect to this router, okay? They're not connecting to the modem from the ISP, okay? So these all, we're gonna put it up on a screen right now and hopefully it makes sense to you. But these routers, and again, we're talking about Linksys, Netgear, Asus, they all have a default IP address, which is also referred to as a gateway. Most of these today are 192.168.1.1, okay? You'll see that where it says routers LAN IP address, okay? That's the private network. When a device connects to this router, you'll see computer one, computer two. Those computers are in DHCP mode, and the router will give them an IP address. Everything on your network communicating to your router needs an IP address. So computer one, its address is 192.168.1.100. Computer two, that's the second device to connect to the router. The router is given that 192.168.1.101. Okay, beautiful. So that they can communicate with the router. They're live on the internet. What we see here is the security camera, okay? If it is shipped in DHCP, which again, most of them are not, the camera will do the same things as the previous two computers. It's going to allow the router to issue it the next sequential IP address, which would be 192.168.1.102. So if the camera's in DHCP, that's what will happen. But what if it was shipped in static, which most of them were? We've already discussed Hikvision. When it comes shipped from the manufacturer, it's going to be shipped at 192.168.1.64, okay? And that would work, right? With a Netgear or Linksys router, that should work. It doesn't matter that it's in static IP. because that IP address matches the gateway or the LAN of your router. Same is true with Dahua, okay? Dahua comes shipped 192 period 168 period 1 period 110. That's going to be on the same gateway. So in this scenario, we will have no problem locating the camera using IP scanner. Where we run into problems is in the next scenario. So yeah, so on this slide, we see where we get ourselves into a conflict. So in this situation, we are using the internet service provider's modem, which has a built-in router. And that is giving us a LAN with an IP address of 10.1.10.1. Okay, we'll refer to that as the gateway. You'll see these two computers, they are, as most computers, in DHCP mode. So when we plug them into that 10.1.10.1 gateway, they take on those addresses, right? 10.1.10.2 is computer one, 10.1.10.3 is the second computer. But look at our security camera. That's where we have a problem. It came shipped, again, with that static IP address of 192.168.1.64, and it cannot communicate with the LAN, which is 10.1.10.1. So to make the communication work and to make this camera discoverable using our advanced IP scanner tool or our ONVIF scanning tool, we need to get that camera out of static mode into DHCP mode, reboot the camera, and when it reboots, it will take on the 10.1.10.1 gateway of our Comcast modem, okay? So what we're gonna do, we're gonna do this real time. I have a camera that is in factory default mode, okay? It's just been shipped, it hasn't been networked. We're gonna plug it into our network. And I know my LAN is 192 period 168 period 0 period 1. And I know this camera because it's a Dahua camera. It has been shipped with 192.168.1.110 as its static IP. So when I try to pull it up using a scanning tool, I'm not going to find it. It's not live. So I'm going to show you how to find it. I'm going to show you how to switch it to DHCP and how to use those scanning tools. Okay, so let's get into it. All right, so we have opened our ONVIF device manager, which is a discovery tool for ONVIF compliant devices. And as you can see, the camera is not showing up. It is not being located on our system, just like it would not be located with the advanced IP scanner. We've already identified the root cause of this. The camera is on a different gateway than our computer. Okay, our computer is in DHCP. It's getting the 192 period 168 period 0 period 1 gateway from our router, and we know the camera is at the IP address 192 period 168 period 1 period 110. So we need those gateways to match in order to communicate with the camera to put it in DHCP mode to reboot it and to have it be assigned a favorable IP address from our router, okay? So the first thing you're going to want to do is find the IP address of your gateway. To do that, you simply hit the search button. You're going to type CMD, and you'll have an option for command prompt. Type ipconfig, ipconfig, hit enter, and it will tell you what your gateway is. Just like I told you, it's 192.168.0.1. We know the camera is at 192.168.1. .110. So because it's not the same gateway, there's a broken link. This will also tell you that your device, your client, in this case a laptop, what IPv4 address that has from your router, which is 0.16. Okay. So with that said, we know we need to change our gateway. And to do that, what we're going to do is we're going to hit the Windows button on your keyboard and the letter X, just like so. You're going to click on Network Connections. And this next step will depend on if you are hardwired or connected to Wi-Fi, okay? But you're gonna have to hit, as you see, we're on Wi-Fi here. We're gonna have to hit Wi-Fi and go into our properties. If you're hardwired, you'll go into Ethernet properties.
and you're going to have to change your IP assignment from DHCP to static. Okay, so we want to click manual, turn on IPv4, and just type 192.168.1.9. Our subnet, 255.255.255.0. Okay, just like so. So now we're changing our gateway from point 0 to point 1, which is consistent with the camera. Therefore, once we do this, we will be able to pick it up with that discovery tool. Let's hit save and see what we have. All right, so let's go back into our ONVIF device manager. And lo and behold, look here, friends, we have found our camera. 192.168.1.108. So we will be able to log into the camera at that IP address using any browser, and we'll change the networking mode of the camera from static to DHCP. So let's go ahead and open that up in a browser. Because this is the first time the camera has been logged into, it will ask us to activate the camera and come up with the administrative password. So you're going to have to come up with a 8 to 32 character password for your camera, which we will do. And you want to specify a recovery email address. In the event you forget that password, they'll send you a link to reset it. A lot of people skip this process, and it's very important. Because more often than not, you will forget these over time. Okay, so we'll go ahead and save that. The initialization has been completed. If you want to use the phone app to view this network's camera, there's a link to this process using the phone app above right now. But basically, you can download the Dahua DMSS app on your mobile phone. Once you do that, you can scan in this QR code. And once you do that, you'll be able to pull up this camera live on your phone. This is called P2P technology. It's very, very simple. No more port forwarding and all that stuff. We're going to auto check for updates. Perfect. And then we can log into the camera with the password we just created. Okay. Okay, once we log in, you can see the camera is actually looking at a wall. Fascinating. But the purpose of this video is to change the internet setting. So we're going to go over here to setting. And before we deal with the network settings, we can change the time because I see that as off. Just go into system, general, date and time, and hit sync with PC. And that will change the time date stamp of your camera to match the PC. So we've done that. But yes, we're going to go to network and we're going to go to TCP IP on a Dahua camera. It would be the same thing with Hikvision or whatever vendor you're using. And here's static. That's how it's shipped by the manufacturer. We simply want to switch it to DHCP. And once we do that and hit save, the IP camera will reboot. We can put our computer back into DHCP mode, and we will see this camera will change its IP address from the 192.168.1.108 to our gateway, which is 192.168.0. Okay, so let's go ahead and do that. There's the save. And it's rebooting. All right, we are in the home stretch now. What we have to do is put our network settings for our computer back into DHCP mode. To do that, we're going to hit the control button on the keyboard and the letter X once again. We're going to go back into network connections. We're going to pick Wi-Fi. With this computer, we are connected to the internet via Wi-Fi, and we're going to go to our properties. And as you can see, there is where we have changed from DHCP to manual connection at 192.168.1.9. So we're just going to edit this and go back to DHCP, just like that. We're going to hit save, make sure the settings applied, and then we can reconnect to our internet. And once again, the computer will be assigned an IP address by our router. Okay. All right. At this point, we are reconnected properly to our internet. And if we open our ONVIF device manager, our scanner should now locate that camera on our gateway. As you can see, it rebooted, and it is on the 192.168.0 gateway now. So we could open that up via any browser at its IP address. 192.168.0.19. Just like that. There it is. So there is a little bit to it. When you have problems, when you have issues finding those cameras on your network, it's not that they are not there. They're there. They're just not on the proper gateway. So we want to change the gateway of the camera to match the gateway of your routing device. Once you do that, using the steps we just covered, you will be able to find the camera using advanced IP scanner or the ONVIF scanner that we just shared. Hopefully the video was useful. As always, we'll see you in the field.